You're gonna kind of pinch it all together. You see how I'm pinching it together and I'm holding my one side loop.
Okay.
You got it? You're gonna take this now, and you're gonna loop it and bring it into the center and pinch it in there also. So as you can see,
is it an even loop? Like,
yeah, so pretty good. Even. You wanna make it as even as possible. So I now have a bow, just like that. Let's see. And you're gonna pinch it all in the middle. Okay? So as you can see already, this, where between your thumb and these fingers holding this middle, mm-hmm. it's gonna get, everything is gonna go into the middle. Okay. So your thumb and your fingers, get them ready to be holding onto a lot, okay? So, for you can, whatever you do on one side, you do on the other to make your bow look even. So okay. To me, most bows, I will sit there and say, I'm gonna make a three loop bow. So I'd have three on one side, three on the other, and there's always one in the middle. And the middle one is a little difficult.
Okay.
But some people do four, some people do six. Six, that'd be 12 bows all the way around. So what you do on one side, you do to the other. So for today, let's make four. Let's do four on one side and four on the other. It's gonna look really nice. So you're gonna kind of gauge it again, right next to that other loop. And we're gonna combine it right into the middle, just like that. So now I have two loop bows on this side. I'm gonna, and you kind of
want to. Does it matter where I'm going? Because.
No, just put them either on this one side, the other side, or
on this side.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah. And then most ribbon is printed on one side. So when you do your loop, you want to make sure that's the side that's coming through.
Okay.
So you might have to turn it backwards. You might have to turn it forward. It's however. The ribbon is, I kind of just go with however the ribbon is laying. You know, like when you roll up a garden hose, you just kind of go with the way that it's, it naturally wants to go.
So you flow with it.
You flow with it. So I have two loops on this side.
Okay.
You got two loops on both sides? So then, like, as you can see, I have two on each side. Now, like what I'm saying, go with the flow. This ribbon is already naturally going backwards like this, so to make it easy, I'm just gonna put it right behind it. Like, I already kind of, the loop is already kind of formed right there.
Okay, so
I already have
mine.
My third loop right there.
So
nice.
That's mine.
So you have really big, thick ribbon.
Mm-hmm.
I would say your bow right now could probably do three on each side. It's gonna look amazing, and then we'll do the one in the middle. So just do one more loop on each side. Well, I fit, so I have a smaller ribbon. I'm gonna do four on each side.
Okay. And it is tricky to hold on to.
Yeah, it starts to, your fingers start to cramp.
Yeah, okay.
So again, my natural ribbon is kind of just flowing out that way. I'm gonna come right into the middle with it. And I'm kind of, like with them being there, you can kind of gauge that they're all about the same size. So then one more loop on each side. One's gonna go right in the middle right there. And then I'm gonna turn this one out this way. And what's great about wire ribbon is later, after we tie it all together, you can manipulate it however you want.
Just fluff it up?
Yeah. But once you're ready, we're gonna do that. So this is the tricky part. Even with that Hubo that I was talking about. So that Hubo, her mom was teaching us how to do this, but that was basically going one this side, one that side, one up, one down. It's a little bit more tricky with the pew bow because you're making one like this big to put on a wedding pew. But she taught us how to do it. It was pretty cool. So, but the middle part is this tricky part. So you got three on each side. So here, you have this ribbon right here, right? You have your ribbon hanging down.
Yeah.
So this middle part, I'm just going to show you. You're going to take it. Uh-huh. You're going to make a very, like a little loop.
Gracious.
It's gonna go right in the center. Do you see? Like, look, see it here. Like, you're gonna turn it.
Try to make a loop, all
right. Turn it, and you make a little loop that's gonna go right in the center, and you gather it all right in the middle. That's my little loop right there. Do you see it?
Okay, I'm trying.
So look, I'm still holding on to everything. I'm gonna make. I'm pinching it.
Okay, how did you do it? Okay, now I'm here.
Okay, let me see. Turn on. Let me see. Where's your? Okay. You're holding it all where? It's okay.
I know, I'm just
like, where's your thumb?
Hold it on.
Where's your?
My thumb is okay.
Okay, you're holding it. Okay.
I'm just trying to make sure it doesn't fall off.
Okay, where's the ribbon? Okay, so come around. Okay, somehow.
Sorry,
okay, let me do. Let me. I'll help you. One second. Okay, so I'm gonna. I have my ribbon. Actually, my ribbon is by. my thumb in the front of my bow. This is the front of my bow, okay? I'm gonna take it and I just kind of tuck it. And I'm gonna let go of my thumb for a second and tuck it in there. See how I made a tiny little loop right in the middle? But look, so let me show and then I'll help you. So this ribbon is still hanging down, it's still attached. Now we're gonna take this ribbon. Look, Cynthia, I'm gonna take this ribbon, I'm gonna put it right through the middle here. This is where you don't wanna let go. Uh-huh. Put it right through the middle. This ribbon is gonna tie all these together. Keep that out there. I flip it over, flip it down, keeping it all together, don't fall apart. And now my bow, of course, is getting smashed up. It looks horrible.
It's okay, don't worry. Don't
because you can re-fluff it. So I'm gonna tie a knot right here, like this, just holding it all together, uh-huh. Look.
Oh, nice.
And I held it all together. Now, these are my ties.
Yeah.
I'm gonna cut this off. Keep it kind of long, because I don't know how long the package is. So, tie this into a knot. So these two ties in the back right here, like let's say I'm doing a wine bottle. When my bow is finished, I'm gonna take these and tie it around the wine bottle.
Oh, this is okay. Gonna
hang down. And then I would also probably tie another piece around the wine bottle so those can hang down as tails. Mm. And this one is the middle tail. So then, now I have it. This bow is here, look, it's a bow, right? It's all together. Now, I'm just going to sit here and manipulate and fluff my loops. And I can move them up